Welcome to the Food Awareness Campaign of Sanjeevani Clinic. Now today's topic is glycemic index. Now what is glycemic index? Glycemic index is an index which represents in how much proportion your sugar will increase after taking that kind of food. Okay, so how much is the speed of increase in the sugar levels that will determine by this glycemic index. Okay, so for example, if you take some rotis, rice and dals, so that things or that food is having medium glycemic index. Okay, but if you eat milk, if you drink milk, if you eat fruit with low glycemic index, okay, for example kiwis, for example you can have very less glycemic index. There are various food which the list I have been provided you on the screen. So you can read this and you can determine how much is the glycemic index of this food. So if the glycemic index of the food is below 55, it is considered as low glycemic index food. Milk and many pulses are having low glycemic index. So you can eat it in an apple in very good quantity. Then the glycemic index, if it lies between 56 to 69, then that food is considered to be the medium glycemic index. So in medium proportion or in a small proportion, in good proportion, you can eat that. That is, you can have the rotis, you can have the mango, you can have banana. All these are having medium glycemic index food. And the glycemic index which is having more than 70 is the high glycemic index food. For example, sugar. For example, popcorn. Yes, popcorn is having high glycemic index. So be aware, diabetic people should not eat popcorn in much quantity. And then you can have watermelon. Watermelon is also having high glycemic index. So be aware while eating the amount of watermelon you are eating, because that will increase your sugar in a very rapid manner. Okay, so if you eat a food which contains fibers, for example rotis, rice, vegetables, fruits, then they will not increase your sugar in a speedily manner, in high speed. Okay, but if you eat the food which is having high glycemic index, they will increase your sugar in high speed. So you will have to increase the dose of the medicine. Okay, so and if you are at the corner stage, boundary stage, that you are not having diabetes but your sugar remains at the higher level, in that case also, if you know this glycemic index concept, then you can reduce that amount of food, kind of food in your diet, or it can reduce the quantity of that food, then you can determine the quantity. If it is having low glycemic index, you can have in some good quantity. Medium glycemic index, a little quantity, or in a medium quantity, so that you can have that roti, you can have that rice, you can have mango, you can have banana also. But while eating your popcorn, your watermelon, your sugars, your cake, your pastries, your ice cream, you have to limit the quantity if you are having diabetes, because they are going to surely increase your blood sugar levels in a high speed. Okay, that is the one thing what I want to do. So if you add something in that which will reduce that glycemic index, that for example if you add ghee in that, or if you add fibers in your diet, then that will decrease your glycemic index of that food. Then the concept comes glycemic load, that you don't have to care about this. Only thing that if you eat it in a limited quantity, that glycemic load will not increase. What is glycemic load? So for example, if you take apple is having around glycemic index 40. It is low glycemic index food. Okay, then in 40, but it contains around 13 gram of carb. Okay, so in that 13 gram of carb with the glycemic index around 40, it is having a load of glycemic load of 5. But if you take potato, which is having glycemic index around 80 and which contains 14 gram of carbohydrate, then the glycemic load will be 10. So it increases the glycemic load. So if you consider this, then but potato is having more glycemic load than that of the apple, that you naturally know because of that glycemic index concept. So don't go into the details of glycemic load, but consider the glycemic index and accordingly you can manage your food. So So how you can decrease the glycemic index of the food? By increasing the fat content. For example, you can have ghee in rice and dal. By increasing the fiber content, for example, you can add salads, you can have raita, you can have kochambir in that, and then it will increase the glycemic index, decrease the glycemic index of that food, and you can have that food in a good quantity. So one more thing is that every time it is not compulsory that food will increase your sugar tremendously. If you are eating in a less quantity, it will not increase your sugar tremendously. But you should know that food is going to increase your sugar tremendously. You will eat in a less quantity. So if you want to try various foods that you like, but they are having high glycemic index, then what you have to do? You have to eat that food and get your sugar done after 2 hours. Then accordingly, you can make a list. Okay, after this, I don't have to worry about, because my sugar has not increased so much that I have to care about that. Okay, so this is the concept regarding glycemic index, where you have to take care of your blood sugar levels, and that will easily go away with the blood sugar levels. I have various patients, young patients, those who don't know this concept, I have make them learn this concept. Now they are going to know that which will increase their sugar, which will not, which amount they have to take into their food, in their food content, so that they will not increase their sugar, but they can eat that also. So if you want something, if you want watermelon, if you like watermelon, eat it in a less quantity, in a less amount, then it will not increase your sugar. But if you are going to eat it in much amount, much quantity, then that will definitely increase your sugar. You can see this on your blood sugar levels by taking the blood sugar levels before eating and after eating, 2 hours after eating. So that will make you educated regarding this glycemic index and glycemic load, so that you can control your sugars in various manners, and so that if you know what is going to happen in my body with that food, then you definitely be aware about that food content. So like this, to see various videos regarding this food awareness campaign, you can have, I have given you the link in the description book. And if you want this type of information should reach to each and every people, please do like, share and subscribe our videos, and be healthy throughout your life. Thank you very much.